Let us consider one dissolution of a partnership firm. Look at this sum on the screen. Jay, Ajay and Vijay started partnership firm to do business on 1st of January 2003 to share profits and losses in the ratio of 5:3:2. On that day, their capital was 50,000, 30,000, 20,000 respectively. Capital of Jay 50, capital of Ajay 30, capital of Vijay 20. This is the capital as on 1st of January 2003. On 31st of December 2003, they decided to dissolve their firm. On that date, firm's position was as follows. So you are given the details of assets and liabilities as at the end of the year. Started on 1st of January 2003, dissolved on 31st of December 2003, so 1 year is the time span. At the end of the year, building 50,000, machinery 30, debtors 40, bills receivable 10, stock 20, creditors 60, bills payable 10. These are the assets and liabilities information given to you. Debit balance of profit and loss account is 10,000, so he has already worked out the profit or loss during the year and he has found a loss of 10,000, cash balance 10,000. On dissolution, assets and liabilities were disposed of as follows. Jay takes over the building at 20% more than the book value, against which he has accepted to pay the creditors. So, building is taken at 20% more, 50,000 building, 20% more, 10,000 more, 60,000 is the value at which building is taken by Jay. Jay is the receiver, debit the receiver. Jay account debit, asset realization account credit. Against which he has accepted to pay the creditors. Now Jay is a partner. He has accepted to pay the liability of the firm. When liability is taken by a partner, partner is a giver to a firm. Giver's account is to be credited. So partner's capital account will be credited for creditors taken over. So entry for creditors taken by Jay is creditors are settled. Settlement of liability is debited to realization account. So realization account debit to Jay's capital account credit for creditors being taken. Ajay takes over machinery at 10% less than the book value and stock at 10% more than the book value, against which is accepted to pay the bills payable. Vijay takes over the debtors at 20% less than the book value. This is how assets and liabilities are being realized and settled. Bills receivable are valueless, nothing can be realized. So we can't write the entry for the amount not realized at all, it's a loss. And bills receivable are already debited to realization account and realized nothing. So debit to realization speaks of loss accounted for bills receivable being unrealized. Government levy of 800 was outstanding for one complete year, which was paid. Unrecorded liability paid 8,000. The journal entry for repayment of unrecorded liability realization to cash. Dissolution expenses paid 3,000, realization to cash is the entry. Calculate 10% annual interest on partner's capital. Notice that. Here he has already worked out the debit balance of partners. Debit balance of profit and loss account 10,000 is already there. But he has not taken into consideration the interest payable to the partner. So we are required to prepare profit and loss appropriation account. Find out the net divisible loss amongst the partners. And that will be distributed amongst partners in the profit sharing ratio, that is 5:3:2. Now I am required to prepare realization account, etc. Realization account, partners capital account, cash account and profit and loss appropriation account. But I would prefer to prepare first of all the balance sheet as on the date of dissolution to start with the sum. So let us first prepare the balance sheet as on the date of dissolution. Now see, this is the capital at the beginning of the year. Jay's capital is 50,000. Capital of Ajay 30,000. Capital of Vijay 20,000. capital opening balances are recorded in a balance sheet as on 31st of December 2003. Building 50,000, asset, machinery 30,000, appears on the asset side, debtors 40,000, I write on the asset side of the balance sheet, this is the balance sheet that I prepare on the date of dissolution, bills receivable 10,000 also appears on the asset side, stock 20,000 also appears on the asset side, creditors will appear on the liability side of this balance sheet 60,000, bills payable 10,000 liability side, debit balance of profit and loss account will appear on the asset side, and cash balance also will appear on the asset side. Now total of this balance sheet should agree, that is 170,000. So this is a balance sheet as on the date of dissolution. Now I start the sum for accounting for dissolution on the basis of this balance sheet. So here I prepare realization account, cash account, partners capital account and profit and loss appropriation account. First step to solve the sum is to copy the balance sheet in the relevant accounts. How to copy? All assets to be realized are debited to realization account. All asset liabilities to be settled are credited to realization account. Capital balance is recorded in the capital account. Cash balance is recorded in the cash account as opening balance. And this profit and loss account debit balance will appear in the debit side of profit and loss appropriation account. Now let me start. Building debited to realization account. Machinery debited to realization account. Debtors debited to realization account. Same for bills receivable. Stock 20,000 found on the debit side of realization account because it is to be realized. Debit balance of profit and loss account will be recorded as opening balance brought down. Cash balance 10,000, opening balance brought down. Asset side is over. Now I want to copy or consider the details on the liability side. Capital of Jai. Jai's capital account credit. Ajay, balance brought down 30,000. Vijay 20,000. Recorded in the credit side of this capital account 20,000. Creditors to be settled. Credited to realization account, bills payable same way, credited to realization account. Copy of the balance sheet is over. Now next step is to realize the assets and pay the liabilities. Here, Jai takes over building 20% more than the book value. Building 50,000, 20% more, so 120%. So 50,000 into 120%, 60,000. This is the value at which Jai has taken the building. Jai is the receiver, debit the receiver, Jai account debit to realization account credit. Realization account is credited for that, notice it. Against which is accepted to pay the creditors. Creditors are 60,000. Jai has committed to pay the creditors. Okay. Obligation taken by a partner. Partner is a giver to a firm. So Jai's capital account is to be credited. And the liability settled is debited to realization account. So notice, realization account debits 60,000 to Jai's capital account credit. B, creditors assumed by Jai, taken by Jai. So this point is over. Next, Ajay takes over machinery 10% less than the book value. Machinery 30,000, 10% less 27,000. While stock 10% more than book value, stock 20,000 plus 10%, 110%, 22,000. Let us calculate. Machinery 30,000 into 90%, 27,000 is the exchange value. This is the value at which Ajay has taken. He has taken stock 10% above, so 110% of 20,000, 22,000. 49,000 is the total value of assets taken by Ajay. Ajay is the receiver, debit the receiver, Ajay account debit to realization account credit 49,000. So Ajay account debit, realization account credit 49,000. Now against which accepted to pay the bills payable. Bills payable are 10,000. Ajay has taken the liability. When partner takes the liability, partner is a giver to a firm. So, and the liability is settled, so bills payable account debit 10,000 to Ajay capital account credit 10,000. Bills payable taken by Ajay. Now see. Next, Vijay takes over debtors 20% less than the book value. Debtors are 40,000, 20% loss, so 80% of 40,000. So 80% of 40,000 means 32,000 is exchange value. Vijay has taken, Vijay is the receiver, debit the receiver, Vijay account debit to realization account credit. Now next, bills receivable are valueless, nothing could be realized, nothing could be realized. So no entry. No amount could be realized from bills receivable, so no entry will be passed on the credit side of realization account. Government levy 8,000, unrecorded liability pay. When the payment of unrecorded liability takes place, realization account debit to cash account. So here realization account debit 8,000 to cash account credit 8,000. Same way, dissolution expenses are 3,000 pay. What's the entry? Realization account debit to cash account credit. Calculate 10% interest on partner's capital. Opening balance of partner's capital are 50,000, 30,000, 20,000. Interest at the rate of 10% is required to be calculated. So, 50,000 into, let me calculate the interest. 50,000 into 10%, 5,000. Jai will get 5,000 as interest on capital. For Ajay, 30,000 into 10%, 3,000. For Vijay, 20,000 into 10%, 2,000. This interest on capital debit into profit and loss appropriation account, partner's capital account credit. Profit and loss appropriation account debit to partner's capital account credit. Profit and loss appropriation account debit to Vijay's capital account credit. This is how this interest on capital is granted to the partner. Now I will have a divisible loss in a profit and loss appropriation account, that is 10,000 plus 10,000, 20,000. So this 20,000 is the loss that will be distributed amongst partners in the ratio of 5:3:2. Let us work it out. 20,000 into 5 by 10, 10,000. 20,000 into 3 by 10, 6,000 is the share of Ajay in loss. And similarly, 20,000 into 2 by 10, 4,000 is the share of Vijay in loss. Now you know that losses are debited to the partner's capital account and profit and loss appropriation account is credited for that. So, Jai capital account debit 10,000 to profit and loss appropriation account credit. Ajay capital account debit to profit and loss appropriation account credit. And this Vijay, noticing Vijay's capital account debit to profit and loss appropriation account credit. So losses are distributed, realization losses here to be distributed. Total of credit minus total of debit shows you the profit, or total of credit minus total of debit gives you the loss. Here on the debit side, total is stood at 31,000. From that, if you deduct this total of credit, you will get a loss of 20,000. This realization loss is also required to be distributed in the profit sharing ratio, that is 5:3:2. So here, let me work out. 20,000 into 5 by 10, share of Jai. 20,000 into 3 by 10, share of Ajay. 20,000 into 2 by 10, share of Vijay. This is also loss, but it's a realization loss. This loss also debited to the partner's capital account. So, Jai's capital account debit to realization account credit. Ajay's capital account debit to realization account credit. And Vijay's capital account debit to realization account credit. So realization loss is distributed amongst partners in the ratio of profit sharing. Now, I am required to redeem the capital, or capital accounts are to be settled. The credit balance of capital accounts are payable and debit balance of capital accounts are recoverable. Notice it. So here in case of Ajay, 50 plus 60 plus 5, 1,15,000. And 1,15,000 minus 60 plus 10 plus 10, 35,000 is the credit balance that we are required to pay to Jai. So Jai's account debit to cash account credit. But in case of Ajay, 49 plus 6 plus 9, this is a greater total than this total. So debit side total is 61,000. 61,000 minus 43,000. So 18,000 is the amount recoverable from Ajay, because this debit total is more than credit total. Debit total is more than credit total. So what happens? 18,000 is recoverable cash account debit to budget, capital account, credit, same way, 40,000 minus 22,000, 18,000, that is to be recovered from BJR, cash account debit to BJR's capital account credit. This is how the capital account got settled at the end of dissolution process. The credit balance of the partners are redeemed and the debit balance of partners are recovered. So when the amount is recovered from the partners, cash account debit to capital account 18,000, cash account debit to capital account credit 18,000, like that. Now my cash account should tell you 35 plus 11, 46,000 is the total. Same way, 46,000 is the total on this side. So this is how my cash account tells. Now this is an important sum to be noticed. You must have understood it. Thanks to all of you.